でるでるでる。Alright. Hello, U.S. votes. Morning. Do 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 do. Okay. Here we are. Day 2, Inktober. And today I want to do some animal skulls. We've been doing a lot of mechanical stuff lately. And I know, I mean, although I kind of feel like bones and stuff is sort of mechanical looking. But anyway. Make sure I'm in the frame here. Yeah. Okay. Here, I need to scoot. Okay. Hey, Killer Den. Good morning. Okay. Sorry, I got a little allergies, but I'm hopefully gonna clear up soon. Actually, let me do a little posty post here. Sorry, I'm a little late today. One second. Copy that. But yeah, today we're gonna do some animal bones, and I think it'll be fun. Skulls and things. Okay, I'm excited. I'm excited to see your drawings. Okay, so here we go. Let me close this up. Let's try, I'm gonna go for this owl skull first. I think that's kind of nice and big shapes. Let's reset this for 5 minutes. Okay, so yeah, we're running on a 5-minute timer, everybody. So here we go. Yeah, make sure you got your cookies ready, your tea, whatever. First drawing of the morning. And, Inktober's started, so we might as well latch on to it a little bit. I'm not really following the topics for Inktober, but I guess the point is just to draw, right? So it doesn't matter what topic we do. It's kind of dark over here. It's kind of tough, actually, these skulls. A lot of stuff to get, a lot of details to get lost in. Be careful, make sure you're not, I don't know. Let me try to get some more light in here. It's kind of dark. Okay. Yeah, and sometimes for these little short drawings, it's nice to have a. You can just pick out some shadows with a thick marker. I think that makes the drawings look more substantial a little bit. I gotta figure out my microphone here. Popping out. This is an owl skull, I think. Doesn't look like an owl at all. I guess the nose should be shorter here, maybe. Super jumbo Sharpie somewhere around here. Oh, here it is. Wonder if I can. Yeah. Okay. Let's try. These are kind of neat. This is a red carrion crow skull. Okay, here we go. Hi, Sina. Good morning. Allergies today. Thanks. Hi, Paul. You drawing today? I wonder if this will be horrible if I try to draw like this jumbo. Oh my God. feels nice. It's nice and soft. I just want to be like Ashley Wood, that's all. Oh, nice, man. That's pretty awesome. Looking forward to some of your, man, I haven't seen your traditional stuff in a long time. I'm excited. A big Sharpie is kind of fun. I wonder if I could use a water pen, maybe. Leak through to the table here. Maybe I need a little dish for some ink or something. Sorry guys, I should be more prepared for these by now. It's only been a million Ugh, allergies. Okay, let's do the next one here. Let's go back. Boop 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 boop. Bald eagle skull. Alright. Ooh, actually, this parrot, this macaw is kind of cool. Alright, let's go for macaw. Let's see. Cena and US votes are getting murdered by these skulls. So. Alright, here we go. Excellent. So I guess guys, if I mean there's a lot of little tiny shapes in here, but maybe it might be easier to go for the outline first, possibly. I'll try that and see how it goes. Let's make it really round and also simplify a little bit, so the bones have a lot of little lumps and stuff in them, so you just kind of ignore a lot of it and just pick out the parts that you think are the most important. This is pretty tough. Got a big hole here.
giant eyeball eye socket. Maybe I'll use my regular Sharpie over here to do all the inside lines. They're pretty thin and delicate. I don't think I can do it with the big one. Try to almost like draw a cartoon of it. It's a little bit simpler because we only have 5 minutes. So you're not gonna get all the little hairs and cracks and squiggles. Just, you have to ignore a lot of it. And it's kind of fun to decide which parts you're gonna keep and which you're gonna get rid of. Decisions. Right. I need this one and this one here. I'll try to do some shading. Maybe I should just use this pen. Okay. And yeah, for anybody watching here, we are doing Inktober drawing, so feel free to join in. Just warming up, basically. And then maybe we'll do a little bit of design afterwards. Let's try this opened mouth macaw here and give that another 5 minutes. Alright. Here we go. So here's your chance, US votes. You can redeem yourself. You get a second chance at the macaw. So try to keep it as simple as you can. So maybe that means ignoring a few bones, or maybe you can stick to the silhouette and then fill it in after. Or like all this little section of bones here, there's you know, a few different ones in here. But you could just put in a very lightly, like a little gesture of what that line is doing. It's just a straight line, pretty much. And then this other On the far side, it to me it feels more curved. Wow, so the bottom of the beak is really flat, actually. It has like kind of a scoop look to it. I never realized that. Okay, and then once you have that bigger shape, then it makes it easier to figure out all the other little tiny things. Like, okay, maybe there's a little hole up here, and then there's another hole here. Since I have this water brush, I'm going to try to make some shading here. It's nice you can just kind of use two brushes, and one has the ink and then the other one's just water. Dark, so I'll just use the actual brush. Same thing down here, the tips of the peak are really, really dark. So I gotta make sure to make that that black needs to be much, much darker than the other shadows in here. And it's darker than these deep shadows in here. Oh yeah, let me find some nice royalty-free music. Guys doing so far? Is this death or holy crap, look at this thing. Alright. Here we go. Okay. And you also get a chance to get used to the shapes and then draw it again. Alright, let's do this one here. What is this? Hornbill, yellow, one looks like a shoe. Top shoe. And the coloring kind of looks like dry brush. Resting shoe face. Okay. I'm gonna try to do long drags, get this dry brush look. We got 2 minutes left, so yeah, you can do some shading probably. We have time. Some new royalty-free music comes out soon. Cause I think I've heard all of them at least a few times. Some of them are okay. They're not too bad. Shadow in here. So if you're just joining us, this is a audience participation kind of a thing. So we're all drawing together, and today's topic is just skulls. So we're probably gonna do some other like foxes or dogs or some other animal after this page. Feel free to just join in. And we also have a 5-minute timer. So these are pretty quick little warm-up sketches. Alright, here we go. Next one is this. Get that open mouth. Hey, brush runner. We are doing some birds today. Oh, actually, just skulls. We're gonna do different animals. But here we go. Let's do this open skull. Is your name supposed to be like Blade Runner, Brush Runner, or is that something else? I gave up drawing years ago. I haven't picked up a pencil in 2 decades. We need you, Brush Runner. You're the best. For the shadows of the white part of the bone, I'm just using a water brush. Or you could just use a paintbrush with some water and dilute your ink a little bit. Probably should have diluted it more, actually. Oh, timer already went, sorry. Okay. Who's next? What's next? Let's do. Is there any animal you guys want to do for the to the hey man, it's Diwoo. You got the same brushes? You gonna draw with us today? You gonna draw, man? You gonna draw? Let me get your number. Yeah, so do you guys have any interesting skulls you want to try? Any suggestions? Could do like a fox skull, maybe. Let me see. But yeah, if you want to do any specific suggestion, just elephant skull. Okay, let's see. That sounds fun. Oh, right. Yes, I made your brushes. These brushes have seen more paper than you could ever imagine. Okay. Here we are. That's weird. Very twisty. Very tusky. This fucking song. Heard this probably billion times since starting doing these streams. Ugh. I've had this one for a long time, which probably means I don't draw enough. But and these water ones you can just have forever because you just keep filling it with refilling it. Sometimes, I don't know if you guys do this, but when you're drawing, like, you start your drawing off in one area, let's say the skull, and then you can continue it over here, and then try to meet up back in the middle at some point. I feel like, because sometimes when I try to grow it all out of, like, if I start in one corner and just keep progressing from right to left, sometimes it'll... I don't know, the proportions aren't as good as if I jump around a little bit. I'm not sure. These tusks are pretty interesting. This skull, it's so dark and woody. Yeah, great suggestion. Really interesting shapes here. Minutes 30 seconds. Hurry. I'm gonna try to get the silhouette at least. No, 20 seconds. Didn't make it. is a tough one. I probably should have just made the timer longer on it. Shadow here, I missed. This is important because it's like that's the main shape of the big shape of the skull right here. This scallop. Totally missed it. A tough one. Let's see. Brush furnish says fill the black ones. I didn't know that. I need to figure out how to refill these. These are an elephant skulls. Oh, it's not. Oh, it's a mammoth skull. Oops. Do you ever plot out roughly with points? Not really. Okay. Let's see. Wow. What the hell? Actual elephant skull look like. Damn, so crazy. This kind of looks like Earthworm Jim, or wait, not Earthworm Jim. What's that guy? Some superhero. It looks like a superhero mouth. Like Mr. Incredible or something like that. Okay. Let's do a cute skull now. Maybe that'll. Whoa. What if we look for cute skull? No. Pinterest. Okay, here we are. Okay, if we were gonna do this as an overall shape, it's kind of like a trapezoid. Like boom, boom, and then a curve on a curved trapezoid, maybe. And then from that, then we can start to cut out the holes of, like, here's the nose, maybe cut out a little half circle for the nose. Trying to simplify this down to just straight lines and curves. So all this teeth in here, in the teeth area, I'll just put a straight line and then a little tiny curve at the end, and then another little J shape here. J shape here. So these curves actually have a lot more going on in them. But we can just make it one big sweep of a curve to simplify it. Maybe this one is, we could treat that as straight, but it's a little bit curved, maybe. So you can break. If you have a complicated curve like that, where it's going back and forth, you can break it into sections. Shadow underneath. Last way.
No. Yeah, see now it's all royalty free. Best music in the world. Free music. Ooh. Just kidding, I don't know. This is just YouTube music, I guess. You guys have any suggestions for the next one? Any animal skulls you want to try? Boo, 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 boo. Any animal that's not an elephant? Or, oh, I saw a whale. Somebody wanted to do a whale skull. Let's check that out. Ooh, crocodile would be intense. Alright, we'll do crocodile next. Jeez. Look at this. Here it goes. Hey. Hi. Beluga. Rock and leopard skull. After the whoa. Damn, they just look like a house. Or a tent. This is a scan, 3D scan, huh? All right, let's do this one. This is a baleen whale. Okay. Original Sims piano music. I love the Sims soundtrack. I actually recorded the entire Sims soundtrack and would play it over and over and over again.
But that's not copyright free though, is it? If it is, I'll be playing The Sims from now on till infinity. Okay, here we go. Okay, guys, if you're just joining in, I saw a couple of you pop in. Don't leave yet. We're drawing a baleen whale skull. So, if you want, just join in. We're doing this for Inktober, which is a month-long drawing challenge. And, yeah. So feel free, well, I hope everybody's drawing in the chat. That's the whole point. And then we post our drawings at the end and see what everyone's done. And that's it. It's pretty simple. And we listen to royalty-free music. And yeah, let me know if you guys know any other royalty-free music, because we've been listening to this. I mean, I'm not totally sick of it yet, but I have heard all of these songs multiple times and on many YouTube videos, and it's kind of like the official YouTube music. YouTube music has gotten better though. Like, remember a couple years ago, there was probably like only five different copyright-free songs that everybody had in their videos, and it was super annoying. Now at least there's a couple of them, and the quality is a little bit better. Anyway. I wonder if there's a stream somewhere where people are making royalty-free music daily. Then we can just go, and they make a new song every 5 minutes. Okay, so all this shadow here, I'm just gonna dilute my ink a little bit. All of this. It's a nice big chunky shadow. Who doesn't love a nice solid cast shadow? Always makes my day better. Those nice soft core shadows. sandstorm. That is a horrible idea. Oh, it's a video by Polygon. So it is copyright free. That's awesome. Okay, next we were gonna do, what was the next skull type? It was, my memory is so shit. It was leopard, no, crocodile. Here we go. Which is probably gonna be similar to this. Very long. And flat. See, that just looks like their head. There's no difference between their skull and the head. What the hell? I would be grumpy too if my whole face was a skull. Okay. Sims, I should be drawing. Hey Igor. Encouragement. Look forward to having you back in here again. We will miss your sketches. It's a very lumpy face. Beautiful music. Alright, well, I can try to put on The Sims. It may or may not block all of. I mean, it probably will. Do you guys want to listen to The Sims, or? I'm always up for some Sims, but I know some people think it's really annoying. So, I'm sure my roommates in college thought it was annoying when I played it nonstop. So, I'm sorry to them. Good study music. Because it just, I don't know. I feel like it, any other song, if you listen to it for that long, would be unbearable. But Sim soundtrack, it's just something about it, it's magic. There was also this one called the Uniqlo World Clock. I wonder if it still exists. That I used to listen to on repeat all the time. Let me see. Uniqlo World Clock, where are you? Where is it? Oh. I don't know what this means, but it looks like it means it's gone. Damn it. It was such a cool. Let me see. Maybe we can just play compilation. Yeah, check it out. So weird. This is what I listened to when I was like deep into a project and feeling really desperate and like working all night, all nighters every, and just going crazy from having visions from sleep deprivation, going a little bit crazy. This music kind of makes you feel crazy. I could never tell what's going on exactly. It's really hypnotizing. Okay, anyway, what was next? Tiger? Or leopard, right? U.S. votes, we are almost done actually, because I'm going to finish up this page and that's it, and then we'll be done. So actually, let's make this leopard skull the last one. That'll be a nice close. Before we go insane. Dramatic, okay. Try that out next time. I think I've heard his stuff before. Here. Timer on. Last drawing for the day. This. Hey, Igor. This is gonna get flagged. Might get it blocked in Japan. Playing this music. Wait, is Uniqlo Japanese? Not sure where Uniqlo's from. It seemed like they would be Japanese. They don't have that many teeth on the bottom side, actually. Oh. All right. Okay, guys, that's it. If you did some drawings today and you want to share them, there's a link underneath. It's called Chat Drawings. So you go over here, Chat Drawings. Where is it? Chat Drawings. And then you go in here and you can just put some stuff in there. Let me scan this. But yeah, you upload it right here. This is your first time, you can check out what people have done in the past. Done a lot of cars, actually. A lot of mechanical stuff, penguins, F1 cars, military trucks, blown up tanks, camper vans, Icelandic camper vans. That's one of our favorites here. Icelandic people know how to do their cars. Some spaceships. So yeah, we got landscapes too. We've done a bunch of landscape sessions. So, oops. And you can always go back and look at those too. All the episodes are on the channel. Wait, where are we? How do I see? Okay, let's go down to the bottom. Whoa, we got some new ones from Linda, so. Yeah, yesterday we did K-Cars. So in the meantime, while you guys are uploading, I'll just look at some of the drawings from yesterday. Oh. Did we see Lucina? I don't remember these. These are cool, man. Nice. So yeah, Cena's got some pretty nice shading in here. He's blocking in everything together as one value, which is good. Keeping it very simple. And nice gesture. Nice proportions. Yeah. And we've even got some original designs here from Cena. Nice. This one was really challenging. And got that perspective in there. Pretty good. And looks like a little robot. If I were to give any suggestion, maybe. Actually, I kind of like how you're doing stuff so far. In terms of just being very simple with the lighting and very confident. Which I think you're doing. Maybe. Seems like you're going back and forth a lot on your lines, like do 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 do, even though you seem to be hitting it. So, well, anyway, these are nice. Good quality there. Michelle, I think we saw. Did we see these? I must be going crazy. I like these though. I like his. He got a happy one and an angry one. Turn this down. And here's Linda. So I guess Linda missed us yesterday, but she watched the stream afterwards. So if sometimes people will do that, they'll watch it after the fact, which is totally cool, and then we can just review them, just check out their work afterwards. Let me turn down the volume on this. Sorry. Okay. But yeah, Linda's, I think she's an industrial designer, so she's always doing very clean lines. Pretty nice. Yeah, really clean, really nice. I would say maybe this with the shadow that you got going in here, just keep it going all the way through the bottom here. Like everything that's facing downwards, just give it the shadow. Even though I know that this part, like, it was made of a bunch of little beams and bars, so it's like a lot of tiny pieces. But just to simplify it, since we're doing a quick sketch, it's easier to just blast it all in, like kind of like how you did it over here, all together, just make it all black under. And then same thing over here, just make it all black. Even though, yeah, there's mud flaps, there's different parts in here, it's more complicated, but just to make it easier to look at, you just bring it all together in the black shadow. Yeah, like how you're doing it here, how you're doing it here. I would say don't be afraid to just cover up the lines too. I mean, even if you draw the wheels, you shade in the wheels first, and then you shade the shadows later, and the lines are going a different direction, that can be enough to tell that it's two different parts. Like here you can see the wheel is different from the shadow, even though they're all dark, because, I don't know, you can see that line there, you can see, it's enough to tell. And if you look at photos of cars, sometimes you can't even see the difference between the tire and the floor, the ground, they kind of blend together. So I think this is more like it. But yeah, this is great. Hey man, why is he? And he's like all sad. Cool. And then some very cute, some bunny bot. And I think he's like a looks like a caterpillar chrysalis walking robot. Interesting. And they all have like googly eyes. Very nice. I don't know what this guy looks like, a Pokemon or something. Googlymon. Alright, and then here's Igor from a while ago, I think. Or are these recent? These are awesome. Holy crap. Damn. Yeah, this is from the tractor session a couple days ago. These are sweet. Oh. Like, he's doing studies too? The tracks of like how to do it. And then other. Interesting. This machine was so crazy. It just like cuts down trees or something. I don't know what that. Oh man, I love these. Really cool. Okay, I'm gonna refresh here. See if there's any more. Oh, we got some hits here from US votes. Hey, that's pretty good. The mammoth skull looks, I like that a lot. The shadows are feeling good. Maybe the one thing, this tusk here, this part where the line overlaps, maybe that could have been shorter, like end it right about here in the middle maybe, because when it goes too far here, it sort of becomes like the tusk is folding instead. But yeah, these are great. I like how you're outlining stuff and like going over your light lines. It looks like you're drawing very lightly and then you go over after and make it darker in some parts, which is cool. And we got Crocs. Yeah. You have some. There are many shoe shaped animals, apparently. Cool. And then here's the first page. Nice. Yeah, man, I don't know why you were saying that. These were killing you. They look pretty good. Let's see if I was gonna give a suggestion. I mean, it's tough to do these in ballpoint too, because when especially the shading, you have to spend more time to shade with ballpoint. But yeah, maybe you could try a different pen, or not. These are cool. Maybe. Maybe darker in here, like in the beak, because I remember some of these parts were black, like this, maybe this dark, but over here on the beak, and maybe a little bit closer to dark, this dark on this bird's beak too. But I know that's hard to do with the ballpoint. So yeah, these are US votes online. So yeah, great stuff. And here is Killer Den, Dennis, looking good with the ID style sketching. Copic, nice. Oops. Wait, is this also Killer Den? Yeah, I'll skip over this one for a second. Oh, that's cool. It's with the marker. Yeah. Actually, I might use that darker marker all over his beak, because the beak was like pretty much black, I think. And then the beak would really like pop off from this other lighter bone color. Right now it kind of looks like the whole thing is that light bone material, but then this is just shading of the light bone. If you use a darker marker, that might help. And then here, all right, so here we're getting more into the darker stuff. It's cool. We got an extra side view. With this one, maybe. Okay, so for to help, I guess I didn't really do it very well either, but I remember the skull was pretty dark, like a dark gray color compared to the tusks, which were more of a light color. And ideally, I think I kind of messed this up too, where the skull and the tusk kind of look like the same material, but ideally we should go over this whole thing and just wash it all down and gray, make it all gray. So actually, let me try to do that. This might screw it up, but I mean, just getting all the highlights here, the white parts, and knocking them down a tiny bit. And even just doing that sometimes can help to make it look like a totally different material. Because, I mean, if you look at the photo of this one, it was really obvious that these two are different. So, yeah, I'm going to try to make this a little bit darker. So you guys can try to work on that too, like material differences. Just make sure you're making it really clear when there's, especially when there's a really, really dark material versus a really, really light material. You want to convey that in your drawing too. So I think that helps a little bit. Makes it look like this is definitely, at least like compared to this or this, you know that this is a darker material, right? Anyway. That and then same thing here. I would just get this whole part in here and color it all in with this lighter marker, and that would give us a definite breakout of the material. And then here, that's looking good. I like the cross-section lines in here. This looks very industrial design. Nice. Cool, and then we've got Lucas here with a brush pen. Nice. Yeah, I really like the teeth indication in here. These teeth are, you know, tricky, but yeah. Nice. If you want this part to be, I don't know if you were doing this all with the same brush pen, but I think a water pen would be nice to get these parts more smooth and wetter, the light areas. But you did a really good job with keeping the tones organized in here. Nice. All right. Cool. Yeah, no problem. US votes. And Taylor Dan, you guys, I mean, if you put in the work here, I'm going to try to help you if I can. And yeah. Wow. Look at that. Who's this? John McInnes. How's it going, John? Really tiny pictures, but. And I can't zoom in for some reason. Oh, here we go. Nice. These are sweet. I love how dark you got here on the beak. Yeah. Your paper though is super thin. You definitely need to go to the store and buy some heavyweight paper like cardstock or something. This paper is like, kill me. But man, these are great. I love the tusks on here, and maybe the head. I think the head got shrunken a little bit. I feel like the skull was a little tiny bit bigger. Like 10% bigger. Man, okay, cool. Where'd it go? And then we got another one. Whoa, holy crap. This paper's not having it. Interesting. Yeah, but these are great drawings. I mean, regardless of the paper and the and the ink, these are really nice proportions. I think you nailed it. And the teeth again, that's really nice indication. Nice. Okay. And let me see. I'm gonna refresh it one more time. Just double check. All right. And let me know if you guys, anybody's uploading right now, and we can give you a minute. Oh, actually, yeah. In the meantime, let me, what was I gonna do? I feel like I wanted to show you guys something before we go. Well, anyway, yeah, I think I'm gonna maybe do some Blender stuff later today. We'll see. I'm gonna be preparing some and testing out 2.8 a little bit more. I feel like the 2.8 setup is really getting close to being, I mean, I'm already using it totally, so I'm just gonna go for it. Ah, what am I doing? Never mind. I'm gonna do some 2.8 stuff later, maybe. We'll see. Anyway, let me refresh this one more time. If there's nothing here, we can just call it a day. Yep. But if you're watching this later, feel free to post, like how Linda did, and we'll check out your drawings tomorrow. But anyway, thanks for joining, guys. Have a good rest of your day, and really awesome work. I'm looking forward to next time. Okay, thanks. See ya.